Hi, this is Masood Vatandoust, broker and team leader with the Vatandoust sales team. Toronto Real Estate Board just released the statistics for the month of June on the housing, and we are going to look at the Durham Region homes and extract all the numbers and look at Durham Region and see what's happening in Durham specifically. So from the first graph, you can see that the number of homes sold in 2018, which is the green graph, is 918 units versus 997 in June of last year. Now, last year we were on a slope going down very rapidly in June after the April and May market, and we are catching up with the numbers last year. However, if you look at the other two graphs, which is 2015 and 16, the yellow and the red one, we are still way below those for a normal market. But there's been a lot of things happening in the last year or so, and obviously the market was heating up very rapidly, and that couldn't continue. So the government interfered, and there have been a number of measures brought in by both provincial and federal government, and that has definitely slowed the market down. So now let's look at the prices as to what they have been doing for the average price of homes in Durham region. And in this graph, you see that the prices, we are almost at the same price as last June. Last June, the average price of homes in Durham region was 615,000, and this year is 610,000. So almost the same. And you see some fluctuation. Prices were going up beginning of this year, and then in May we had a slight drop, and then June has gone up again. That's very typical where there are lots of uncertainty in the market and external factors affecting the market. So again, as I said, because of the government interference and rate hikes and stress tests and so on, there's been some uncertainty in the market, and that causes this fluctuation that we can see on the prices. But this is normal, and it's settling down, and it's going to carry on. Now let's look at the third graph, which is really the cause for what is happening, and that is the graph for the supply and demand. And normally 50% is the balanced market, as we call it, and that means if 100 homes came on the market in 1 month, about 50 homes sell. Now in beginning of the year, we were at a balanced market, unlike the previous year, which the numbers were very high in the 80% range, which was a seller's market. But this year, we've been tracking the balanced market beginning of the year. In May, it dropped dramatically to below 40%, and that becomes a buyer's market. We saw lots of price reductions and so on. And now in June, we'll see that the numbers have gone up. And that's a direct result of all the price reductions that we had, and the homes became more in line with what the market is paying for them, and the buyers came back in the market and started purchasing. So we are now at 50%. I wouldn't be surprised to see a bit more up and down in the next couple of months before the market finally settles, and then the prices will start increasing. So for buyers, it's a great time to buy. We are in a balanced market. Forgetting last year's situation, this is typical. Even sellers and buyers, the both of them are, it's a good market for both. And the buyers have got lots of choice in the market. And now you can do home inspection. Financing conditions are back, unlike last year when it was multiple offers and nobody had the opportunity to put conditions in. So great time to buy. If you have any questions and you want a one-on-one talk, please give me a call. I'd be happy to sit down with you and look at your situation and advise you on exactly what you need to do as far as buying or selling a home. Look forward to hearing from you. Bye-bye.